Once again, I'll remind you all for the activity. So complete the activity, okay? Since you all told me that you have Hindi exam, so I'm giving you time. So till Monday, you can do and then post it on Monday, okay? So yesterday we finished till trade. So today we'll continue with that. And this lesson is dealt only with the objectives. Okay. And from next week, we'll start with revision such that it will be easy for you all to. Sorry, Sai Raghav. Within this week, we'll let you know the marks. Okay. So don't worry. Everyone, most of you all have scored good marks. First of all, I must thank you all. So we'll start. Let me start with the class. So we have to start with the trade. Okay. Jean ma'am, I want to share the slide. So the topic we have to start is trade. So yesterday itself I told you what is trade, but today also I'll give you the explanation for that, okay? So what do you mean by the word trade? Export and import of goods, that is from one place to another. So what is export? The products which are developed in one country are sold to another country to make money. Likewise, what is import? Bringing goods from one country to the another country. Okay. So, and we know that is done through the land and also through the sea routes and air routes. Through, that is, trading is done through the land route, landways, then airways, and waterways. That is air routes, sea routes, and land routes. So in the olden days, when kings and queens were ruling the country, trading was done by using bullock carts, camels, and donkeys. These animals were used for carrying goods through the land routes in order to provide safety. So these traders are also moving in caravans. So what do you mean by the word caravan? That is, these caravans were very useful in long distance trade, largely for carrying the luxury goods. Okay. So for example, in the 10th century and all, the route was primarily used by the Southeast Asian traders, and the king's guards, they used to protect these caravans, which consist of very, very expensive goods which are to be traded to the other countries. So foreign trade took place through the sea routes. The local kingdoms in Sri Lanka, Java, Sumatra, Malaya, then Arabia, these places had trade relationship with India. So some of the main items which was used for trading were cotton, wool, silk carpets, ivory goods, gems, and pearls. So now we are going to start with the coastal towns. As we know that coastal areas always have ports, as they are located near the water bodies, that is the seas and oceans. As it has the ports, these coastal towns acts as an important center of trade. Import and export of goods, not only within the country, but also done with the other countries too. And next is craft centers. So in these type of towns, things like pottery, jewelry, textiles and other items are manufactured. And in turn, it led to the formation of many important craft centers. So guilds are the group of people who used to make some materials. So these guilds help the members to get the raw materials and they train them how to make these products and sell the goods. And whatever problem arises, it will be solved among the members itself. Here you can see the guilds, the group of people, how they are making the products. They used to train them and they used to teach how to sell these products and whatever problem, that is disputes, which are arising, it have to be solved by themselves. And next we are going to see about Puhar. So you would have heard about this word Puhar. It is also known as Pumbuhar. It is a town in Mayiladuthurai district in the southern Indian state of Tamil Nadu. It was once a flourishing ancient port city known as Kaveri Pumbatinam. Now it is called as Puhar. In the olden days, it was called as Pumbuhar. And it was considered as the ancient port city, which was named as Kaveri Pumbatinam, which was served as the capital city of the early Chola kings. Okay, next. So these things will be not be in your textbook. So don't see in the textbook. I'll give you some extra information for better understanding. So now I'll tell you about King Karikala. Okay, so this Kaveri Pattinam, which is always called as Kaveri Pumbatinam, it is the chief port in the ancient Chola kingdom. So where it was situated? At the mouth of Kaveri River. It is today identified with Puhar, a town in the Nagapattinam district of Tamil Nadu. So this Kaveri Pattinam is also known as Kaveri Pumbatinam. So King Karikala, he was the founder of Puhar, that is Pumbuhar. So Pumbuhar is an ancient port city which was submerged. What do you mean by the word submerged? That is, some people believe that the ruins can be found under the ocean. It might happen because of tsunami or any other natural disasters. So this region was under Chola kingdom, which is also known for being the only kingdom in ancient India with a naval fleet that fought wars over in the sea. So this Kaveri Pumbatinam on the coast near the Kaveri Delta was a major port town. And the other port town of Nahapattinam as the most important centers of Cholas, that is Kabris, Khabiris. So these two towns became hubs of trade and commerce, and it attracted many religious faiths, including Buddhism. So in this region, many precious, that is merchandise. Precious merchandise means what? Velai madipatra porutkal. These were traded. These materials were traded in this Puhar, that is Kaveri Pumbatinam. So it has been considered as a flourishing port city as well as the capital of the Chola kingdom for a brief period. For a long period. Then the entire town was divided into two parts. So one was used by the traders, foreign merchants, and other working people lived here. And the second part was used by the rulers and the nobles lived in this region. So the total part of Puhar was divided into two parts. One, in that one part, the traders, foreign merchants and others were working people lived here. And in the second part, the rulers and the nobles lived in that another region, the second part. So the port at Puhar was a busy place. So many ships came to Puhar and it brought precious merchandise from the overseas. That is, now only I told you, what do you mean by the word precious merchandise? So some of the items that were traded in Puhar included horses, pepper, gold, precious stones, pearls and wheat. So in this Puhar, many tall mansions were built along with granaries and warehouses. What do you mean by the word granaries? Storage places for storing grains and many things. And warehouses were also built there because trading took place in this region. So since many precious stones, then gold, pearls, all these things have been traded in this region, the people of Puhar stayed away from murder, stealing and other forms of crime. And this region was swept away in a tsunami sometime during the 3rd century BCE. So that is why we say that this Kaveri Pumpattanam was submerged and the ruins were found under the oceans. So with this, we'll end up this lesson. So here you can see under the ocean, the Puhar finding a lost city, which have been submerged because of tsunami. Can you see Kaveri Pattinam here? Here is Nagapattinam. Now it is called as Puhar. This is a map of Mahajanapadas. Avanti, Matsya, Chedi, Vatsa, Kuru, Panchala, Kosala, Malla, Kashi, Mahada, Anga. So this is a map of Mahajanapadas. You can see the coastal area region, which is used for trading. So here you can see Calcutta, Vishakhapatnam, Chennai, Pondicherry, Tuticorin, which acts as a port harbor. Okay, Cochin, Bombay, Ahmedabad, Kandla. So all these regions are important places for trading. So next we'll proceed with the one word. So this lesson is dealt only with objectives. Though it is dealt only with objectives, what is your duty? Your duty is to read the entire lesson, because from anywhere in the lesson, we might ask the question. So it is your duty to read the entire lesson. Understood? So whatever homework we are giving, learn it every day. Choose the correct option. First one, Ashtadayayi was written by மனு, பணினி, சாணக்கியா, பாஹியன். வாட் இஸ் தி ஆன்சர்? தி ஆன்சர் இஸ் பணினி. Now read the first question in your mind. Ashtadhyayi was written by dash Manu, Panini, Chanakya, Pahiyan. The answer is Panini. Learn the spelling for Panini. P-A-N-I N-I, Panini. Second question. The punch marked coins were also known as the dash. The options are Karshapanas, Paisa, Rupiya, Anas. The answer is Karshapanas. Now read the question. The punch marked coins were also known as Karshapanas. K-A-R-S-H-A. Kar, K-A-R. Sha, S-H-A. Panas, P-A-N-A-S, Karsha Panas. Learn the spelling for Karsha Panas. Third question. In northern India, the village headman was known as the dash. Rajan, Krihapati, Grama Bojaka, Guru. The answer is Grama Bojaka. What is the spelling for Grama Bojaka? G-R-A-M-A, Grama Bojaka. B-H-O-J, B-H-O-J-A-K-A, Grama Bojaka. The first urbanization took place during the dash. The options are Mesolithic period, Vedic age, Mauryan period, Indus Valley civilization. The answer is Indus Valley civilization. Now read the fourth question in your mind. The first urbanization took place during the dash. The options are Mesolithic period, Vedic age, Mauryan period, Indus Valley civilization. The answer is Indus Valley civilization. So you all know where the second urbanization took place. Where? In the Gangetic Plain, Central Gangetic Plain. So the first urbanization took place during the Indus Valley Civilization. And next one, Puhar was the capital of the Dash Empire. Mauryan Empire, Chola Empire, Pandya Kingdom, Chera Kingdom. So the answer is Chola Empire. Puhar was the capital of the Dash. Mauryan Empire, Chola Empire, Pandya Kingdom, Chera Kingdom. The answer is Chola Empire. Now I give you 1 minute time. Now read the first question in your mind. And learn the spelling for Panini. Don't waste the time. Make use of the time and learn, children. Now read the second question. The punch mark coins were also known as the dash. The answer is Karshapanas. Now learn the spelling for Karshapanas. Now, third question. In northern India, the village headman was known as the dash. The options are Rajan, Krihapati, Grama Bojaka, Guru. The answer is Grama Bojaka. Now, learn the spelling for Grama Bojaka. Now read the fourth question. The first urbanization took place during the dash. Mesolithic period, Vedic age, Mauryan period, Indus Valley Civilization. The answer is Indus Valley Civilization. Now learn the spelling for Indus Valley Civilization. Fifth question. Puhar was the capital of the dash. Mauryan Empire, Chola Empire, Pandya Kingdom, Chera Kingdom. The answer is Chola Empire. Now learn the spelling for Chola Empire. Now we'll proceed with fill in the blanks. Excavations at dash near Patna revealed a Mauryan palace. So what is the answer? Kumrahar. Kumrahar. So what is the spelling for Kumrahar? Kumrahar. Kumrahar. Excavations at Kumrahar near Patna revealed a Mauryan palace. The second question, the Grama Bojaka collected revenue which varied from 1/6 to 1/12 of the produce. The Grama Bojaka collected revenue, that is the tax, which varied from 1/6 to 1/12 of the produce. Now learn the answer for the second question. Third question. Traders moved in groups which were called caravans. What is the spelling for caravans? C-A-R-A-V-A-N-S, caravans. Traders moved in groups which were called caravans. C-A-R-A-V-A-N-S, caravans. Now learn the spelling for caravans. Fourth question. All the craftsperson who were engaged in a particular craft formed their worn dash or dash guild or shreni what is the spelling for guild g u I l d guild shreni s h r e n I shreni all the craftsperson who were engaged in a particular craft form their own dash or dash guild or shreni learn the spelling for guild learn the spelling for shreni the last question Puhar was located at the mouth of river Kaveri. What is the spelling for Kaveri? K-A-V-E-R-I. Kaveri. Puhar was located at the mouth of river Kaveri. K-A-V-E-R-I. Kaveri. Now I'll give you 1 minute time. Now read the first question. In your mind. Children, make use of the time and learn. Don't sit idle. Learn the spelling for Kumrahar. The second question, the Grama Bojaka collected revenue which varied from dash to dash of the produce. The answer is 1/6 to 1/12 of the produce. Now read the third question in your mind. Traders moved in groups which were called caravans. Learn the spelling for caravans. Fourth question. All the craftsperson who were engaged in a particular craft form their own dash or dash. The answer is guild or shreni. Guild or shreni. Learn the spelling for guild. Shreni. Now read the fifth question. Puhar was located at the mouth of river Kaveri. Learn the spelling for Kaveri. K-A-V-E-R-I. Kaveri. So with this, we will end up the session. Tomorrow we'll do the activities that is in the textbook. Okay, I'll teach you how to do that. Is page number 77. Skill focus as well as I do. I understand. I'll teach you that map you have now. That one as well as the skill focus. I'll teach you and we'll complete that also. And by next week, we'll start the revision for the cycle test. I don't know when the cycle test will be conducted. So we'll finish that. Okay. Okay, thank you, children. Thank you, Jean ma'am.